What's up, guys? So today I'll be talking about this STM32F469I-DISCO. So a lot of people have been leaving comments having trouble setting up the STM development board. So today I'll show you how to set up through TouchGFX and then export that out into STM Cube IDE. All right, let's create a new project and select the board. This is the board I have currently. They do have a new revision board, but this is the board that I have. So we'll start with that one, and I'm gonna name this application 469i-DISCO. Create the project, and I'll just put in a graphic here. Let's generate the code. Okay, close the project. All right, so we're going to import the project. So make sure you have the latest version of STM32 Cube IDE. Current version I have is 1.10.1. So we'll just do a file and we'll do import. Existing project into workspace, and currently I have it selected, so that's why it popped up. But if not, you would be browsing to the location where you export it from TouchGFX, and you gotta make sure that that you select the STM32 Cube IDE folder, select that, and then this will show up and with a checkbox. So we'll click finish. Now, one of the things you notice is, even though you renamed the project in TouchGFX my 469i-DISCO, it comes up with just the board name. So to get around that, to rename this, it's a little bit of a work, but you have to rename some files. So let's close this out. We'll just actually delete it, but we're not going to delete the project. We're still going to keep it. Hit OK, and let's open up the location it's at. And here we need to rename the IOC file, so let's rename that. We'll call that my 469i-DISCO. And then we'll go into the STM Cube IDE, and then we need to open up both of these into a text editor. And currently I'm using Visual Studio Code. And what we're gonna do is look for that name. So let's go replace. I'm going to do STM32, and here's the name that we're looking for. All right, paste that in there. All right, right now it shows that there's 11, so I'm going to select these two. That's to match the whole word, and this is to match the case. And you can see there's 10 in here. So I'm going to move this up to the first location. And anything that says workspace location, that's the one you want to change. So we'll call this my 469i-DISCO. And we're gonna replace that one. It's gonna automatically jump to the next one. So this one's in the workplace location. So we'll change that one. And that one's Git location. So we don't wanna change that. So we're gonna skip it. Skip that. Skip that. That's in the folder. So we don't wanna mess that path up, or the directory to that path, or the path to the directory. I'm getting tongue-tied here. All right, so we'll skip that one. And this one is okay. We can just change this. I don't know what this changes really. You know, it's an ID, but we'll just change that. So rename that one. Then we can rename that one. And that's a workspace path. We change that one and that one. And the rest, it just jumped back to these four that we don't need to change. So we'll just go ahead and save that one. And then we need to open up this project. Click and drag this. And let me move this. All right, so there's only one spot that I need to change. So we'll just change that there. And then we'll save that file. And we're done. And close that out. And then let's open up Cube IDE, and we're gonna import that same project. And it's already been selected. And click Finish. So now you see that it's been renamed to the name that you had typed in. In my case, it was my 469i-DISCO. So now that makes more sense. So if you were to work on several projects using that same development kit, you won't have the same name. You can just rename it so that you know what that project belongs to. All right, so let's do this. Okay, so now you notice there's no IOC file here. So what we need to do is go back to Windows Explorer. And we're gonna grab this and drag it in to here, and we're just going to link to the file and hit OK, and that's the IOC file. Now you can open this up. All right, and here I'm just going to migrate. It's doing some background stuff on my other monitor, just so you couldn't see it. But all right, so now that it's opened up, and one of the things you have to do, because it does use the FreeRTOS, we need to go to the middleware, FreeRTOS, and under advanced settings, we're gonna enable this. Use a new library reentrant. If you don't, it's going to give you a warning when you try to export this or save this project. So now we can save all. You want to generate the code, say yes. Say yes here. Alright, so generated the code, so now we can build the project. So I'll just build it. Let's see if there's any errors here. No errors. I have my STM development board connected to the computer, and I'm just going to run the debugger here. Click that. And it should already have selected my debugger and all that. So just hit OK. Just trying to connect to the debugger. I'll just switch that. It's downloading. All right, so now we can hit the resume button here. And there you go. We got the hello button on the screen. So that's how you would export TouchGFX project. Rename the project and, before you import it into an STM Cube IDE. All right, so we're done. So that's how you build the project from the TouchGFX. And if you like the video, hit the subscribe button, and we'll see you in the next one. See ya!